Well, I'm a noir writer. I'm from San Francisco. I guess you could say I live in Dashiell Hammett's San Francisco because I write about San Francisco in 1940. My character, Miranda Corby, is a female PI, an ex-escort, and a Spanish Civil War Red Cross nurse. She lost her lover in 1937. Her life sort of disintegrates, and she rebuilds it in the rather shady methodology of the private investigator. There were very few women investigators at this time, obviously, but Miranda is one of them. City of Dragons, which was the first of the Miranda Corby series, was a Los Angeles Times Book Prize finalist, and it was a McCavity Award winner for Best Historical Mystery of the Year. It was also nominated for a Seamus, Best Private Eye Novel, and RT Book Reviews, Reader's Choice, Bruce Alexander Award. It was on the top 10 best list of the San Francisco Chronicle, the South Florida Sun Sentinel, and it basically received a lot of critical acclaim, for which I am eternally grateful, both to the critics and the readers who have written me to say that they really enjoyed Miranda in the book. The next in the book, the next in the series rather, is City of Secrets. This one picks up where City of Dragons leaves off. City of Dragons, well, takes place mainly in Chinatown in 1940 and deals with the relationships and the animosities that existed between Chinese Americans and Japanese Americans in Chinatown because of the pressures of the Sino-Japanese War, which is an incident, you know, or not an incident, but a tragedy, really, that a lot of people aren't aware of, or the dimensions of which they're not aware. City of Secrets deals with the murder of a young Jewish woman in San Francisco, and also the murder of a young girl on Treasure Island at the World's Fair of 1940 in San Francisco, who was found. She works at a what we call a flesh show. They had exhibits at the World's Fair, and this is a day and age when you didn't have Playboy magazine and nudity wasn't available on newsstands. So when people wanted to see flesh, they had to go to burlesque houses, strip teases. This is the era of the strip tease. And, you know, in 1940, people were just as curious about sex and nudity as they are today. So anyway, this young lady works at a flesh show called Artists and Models on Treasure Island, where she takes her clothes off and poses very tastefully on a platform while people come in and snap photos of her. It's kind of like DIY your own Playboy. She's found murdered, stabbed with an ice pick, with an anti-Semitic slur written in blood on her body. So this leads Miranda into investigating the growing legions of anti-Semitic, extreme right-wing, fascist, sympathizing groups that actually existed in California up and down the coast, that were found in, yes, progressive San Francisco at the time. The German-American Bund, which was an offshoot of the Nazi Party and was sponsored by the Nazi Party in Germany, was located in Oakland, across the bay at the time.
Is this during the war or after?
This is before the World War, 1940. So it's during the European War. It was really the Second World War before we joined it. So it's during the first part of the Second World War before we came into it. It takes place in May of 1940, right before the fall of France. So at the time, as I said, a lot of people aren't aware of the fact that we had a lot of these hate groups, just as many as we do now. They think, many people think that, you know, the Timothy McVeighs and the hate crimes that we've seen in recent decades are something that's a new phenomenon. It's not. Terrorism, hate crimes, all these things existed then. They may not have been called the same thing, but they did exist. And at the time, there was this isolationist movement across America trying to get us not to help England or agitate against the Nazis. And often the isolationists were linked to these anti-Semitic groups. Ironically, they usually called themselves something very pseudo-patriotic, like the Boston Patriots or American Christian Patriots and so forth, and they usually refer to something to do with the Revolutionary War. In this particular book, the real group that I talk about is called the Musketeers, and they did exist. They were founded in 1937 in San Francisco. And the thing to know about the Miranda Corby series is that as a historian, I'm very, very accurate with my research. My training as an academic was in classics, and the history in here is real history. The weather is real weather. If Miranda sees a movie at the time, that's the movie that was playing at the actual house. One of my best research tools is a 1940 phone book. So the phone numbers in here are real.
Where'd you get that?
I bought it on American Booksellers Exchange. I actually looked for it. I did a search for it because you can find so much information about businesses and names and things that existed. And you want to get the names right. You want to get the addresses right.
Yeah.
So most of the, I mean, like 99.9% of the businesses in my books in the Miranda Corby series were real businesses in San Francisco at the time. Even the escort business that Miranda used to work for, it was Diane's Escort Service and Tea Room, located on Grant Avenue in the city. So all of those things and places are real. And I try to write it so that you have a hard time figuring out what's fictional and what's real. I want to transport my readers there. I want them to be with Miranda while she goes through some harrowing experiences.